Now let's talk about aspirin, or shortened to ASA. Aspirin blocks the formation of thromboxane A2, thus inhibiting the sticking together of platelets and reducing clot formation. The use of aspirin for myocardial infarctions helps to reduce death and the probability of reinfarction and stroke. Aspirin is indicated in the presence of signs and symptoms of acute coronary syndromes, such as those who are suffering from chest pain, chest pressure, or discomfort, including pain radiating into their neck, jaw, or down right or left arm. Another reason for using aspirin is when there are ECG changes consistent with acute coronary syndromes. Examples of this would include, but aren't limited to, ST elevation, depression, or T-wave inversion. Now, before giving aspirin, be sure to ask if a patient has a known hypersensitivity like Sampter's triad. This is a serious condition and can lead to a serious reaction when giving aspirin. Now, they also need to know before giving aspirin if they have bleeding disorders like hemophilia or active ulcer disease or maybe recent gastrointestinal bleeding. Be sure to ask if the patient has a severe allergy like anaphylaxis or asthma related to aspirin as compared to a more moderate sensitivity like sneezing or stuffiness. If the patient does not have a severe allergy to aspirin, the benefits would definitely outweigh the negatives. The proper dose is to administer 2 to 4 chewable aspirin or 162 to 324 milligrams of nonenteric coated aspirin as soon as possible after the onset of symptoms. Aspirin suppositories, usually 300 milligram dose, is a safe alternative if severe nausea, vomiting, or gastrointestinal disorders are present. Remember, in order to achieve a rapid therapeutic blood level, instruct the patient to chew the oral aspirin before swallowing.